Hi everyone, thanks for joining me today. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to sublimate an image onto socks. I'll share with you my design and alignment tips, and most importantly, I'll share my process for making the form that fits inside the sock so that you'll get the best sublimation results. So with that said, let's begin with the design process. So this is the software portion, or the design portion of the tutorial. I'll be using Photoshop CC 2021, and I've created a brand new document that is 8.5 by 11, 300 DPI with a white background. You can use any graphics program of your choosing. This is just the one that I use. So to help me design my image, I like to draw some grid lines or a rectangle to compose within. So I'm going to click on that rectangle box, and under fill, I've got that as no fill. Under stroke, I'm going to choose black, and then I'm simply going to draw a rough outline of that box. All right, then I'm going to go over to the properties tab, and under transform, I'm going to change the width to 3.75, because that's the width of the sock. And then when I measured my design space, I'm going to go with an 8.5. And then when I hit return, that looks good. And I will increase the stroke thickness from, looks like 0.5 millimeter to 1 millimeter. So, whoops, I went too far. 1 millimeter. That way we can see it a little bit better. So I know that by using this rectangle right here, I can compose my image in here, and I can see, kind of visualize how it's going to look on the sock. So let me bring in the image that I'll be using today. So it's this one here. I'm going to click on the layer, Control C on the keyboard, go back to my blank document, Control V for paste, and then I'm going to place that in the rectangle. Now this line right here at the bottom of the rectangle, that's the one that I'm going to line up where the toe changes into the sock. So in this case, there'll be a color change from the gray toe into the white sock. So I'll use that line to do that. So I've moved my image up about 1/2 inch. Next, I'm going to add some text. So I'll just click on the layer that has the image. Then when I click on my text tool, it will automatically create a new layer for me. And then you'll select your text, you know, whatever type you like. And then I've got my color selected here also, but I'll show you how to do that. And then I'm just simply going to place it in that rectangle and type game day. And you could personalize this any way you like. Then I'm going to hit the check mark, go back up to my move tool. Then with my shift key, I'm going to hold that down. And then I'm just going to drag that out to increase the size. Now by holding down the shift key, that will maintain the aspect ratio. And that looks really good. Now, if you did want to change the color, you would simply just double click on that layer. And under this palette here, you could choose like this color. You could choose something from the image. Maybe if you wanted red, I kind of like this. I like the orange, but I think I'll go with the brown. I think that looks nice. Okay, so that's how you change the color. Now, while I still have that selected, you can see that we've got this tool up here. Now, this is the warp tool for the text. So when you click on the styles, you can see there's all kinds of different shapes and stuff that you can use. I'm going to use the arc upper, hit OK. And that looks pretty good. I think I'm going to bring it down just a little bit. And I'm going to increase the size. So again, hold down my shift key. And when I see those little handles, I can increase the size. Now I don't want to take my image all the way out to the 3/4 inches, because once you put this on someone's foot, there's going to be a curve there. So I like to leave myself about 1/4 inch all the way around. So that looks pretty good. So the next thing I want to do is just add some special effects to both of these items right here. So I'll zoom in so you can see this more clearly. And I'm going to click on the layer that is the graphic. And if I go to the right of that layer and double click, this will bring up the layer styles panel. And I'm going to use a drop shadow and a bevel and emboss. Now you've seen me do this before. It's just a personal preference of mine. You don't have to do it. And then I'm going to hit OK. And then I'm going to go back over to that same layer with the graphic on there. And I'm going to right click on the letters that say FX. And then I'll left click on copy layer style. Then I'm going to click on that same space up here in the text area. So I'm going to click there. Whoops. And then I'm going to right click. And then I'm going to say paste layer style. So what that did was the effects that I applied to this graphic, it applied those same effects to the text. So that's a quick way of doing that. So that's the first sock done. So now what I want to do is just draw a selection box around all of those items. Control J on my keyboard. This will duplicate the layer. And I'm just going to move that to the side. And then let me select all of these and center them on the page because that's driving me crazy. There we go. So I've got those centered on the page. Now, one other touch that I did do to this is I would like to mirror one of the images. So I'll click on the image to select it. And then I'm going to go up to Edit. And I'm going to go to Transform. And I'm going to say Flip Horizontal. And I think that looks nice. So you've got, you know, the mirrored right and the left. Okay. Now, of course, this whole image will be mirrored when I send it off to the printer. So that's the front of the socks done. So I'll send those off to the printer. And then let me show you what I've done for the bottom or the soles of the feet. I thought it was kind of cute, you know, have game day with all the different sports. And then, you know, this boy needs a beer, working on my six pack. You know, you could put anything that you like on there. I had these designs that I had purchased from designbundles.net, and I thought those looked kind of cute. So that's the software portion complete. I'll go ahead and send this off to the printer. If you're interested to know the settings that I use or how to set up some presets for your Epson printer, I'll put a link up here and you can view that video. So let me get these printed and then we'll get off to the sublimation portion of the tutorial. So these are the socks that I'll be using today. I purchased these up at the Dollar Tree. These are the, looks like men's size 6 to 12, ultra light. They're actually quite nice socks. And they are 99% polyester and 1% spandex. So this should give me some good color on these socks. So this particular pack came with two pairs. You get the white with a gray toe and heel, and then a full-on gray with the darker gray on the heel and the toe. So let me demonstrate this on the gray sock. I think that might be a little bit easier to see. So the first thing we need to do is take some measurements. So what I've done is just using this line right here that's been creased into the sock, I'm just going to straighten it out the best that I can. Just, you know, just put that right down the middle. And what we're trying to find out is the width of the sock. Okay, so this looks pretty good. So I'm going to take my ruler. And if I measure this across, it's approximately 3 1/4 inches across. So what I'm going to do is add 1/2 inch to that measurement, which will give me 3.75 inches. So you can see that I'll have 1/4 inch on each side of the sock. So that's going to be our first measurement. And then there's different types of materials that you can use to make the form. The first form that I did, I used a piece of corrugated cardstock. But it worked okay, but it's just a little bit thick. So I think what I'm going to do is just change to a cardstock paper. So this is one that I had from my collection of scrapbooking papers, and it's a good thickness, but I think I'll have to double it up to give me the form that I need. So let's go ahead and get this cut. So I'm going to use my handy dandy cutter here, and I'm going to cut two pieces of this at 3.75 inches. So there's the first one. And there's my second one. Okay, so I've got that taken care of. And like I said, I'll be doubling these up. So this will give me enough support so that it holds the sock flat. Next, I'm going to put that sock on here, down towards the bottom. And then I'm just going to, see, make a little bit of a mark on each side where it starts to curve. And then I'm just going to draw a gentle curve. And I'm going to be cutting on the inside of that curve. So you can see this is not exact. And that's what that looks like. And then I'm just with these two pieces together, just hold them steady and cut on the inside of that line. All right, so that looks pretty good. So now I've got that part done for the toe. So let's slip this into the sock. Now that half inch that I added, that was just something that I thought was just enough to give the sock enough of a stretch where it will fit on, you know, most people's foot, and the way that this fabric stretched. So I hope this turns out good. I haven't actually pressed one of these yet. So there you go, that turned out pretty good. I got a nice fit down at the toe. So that looks good right there. And it also looks like it's lying pretty flat. I mean, if you did see it start to curl up a bit, you could just add another sheet of material in there. So this is lying nice and flat on the front, but I've got this heel here that's not lying very, very well. So what I think I'm going to do is just measure how far up this goes. So from the toe up to the top here, it's about 10 inches. I'm going to make a cut. I think I'll do 10 and a half. So let me put a mark here. And then make sure your sock is out of the way. And then I'll cut this at 10 and a half. And I'm going to add one other little thing here. On these edges, they can get, you know, really sharp and poke through the sock. So I found if I just rounded them off a little bit, that really makes a big difference. Now you can see I'm not being super accurate here. If you were going to make a lot of these, you'd be really good just to make a template up on your paper cutter. I think I might do that. This way, now I can pull that sock all the way up, and I know that this will lie flat. I can get this to lie flat on my heat press, and it almost takes care of this part of the heel because I will be putting a design on the back. So that's how I make the form for the socks. So let me make another one so that I've got the pair ready to go. And then what we'll do next is that design that I showed you in the software section. Here's what these look like. So these are the designs that I'll be putting onto the socks. So this will be the front part of the sock, and then this will be on the back. So I'll cut these out. Let me show you, you know, I went on and on about how I use that rectangle to help me with alignment. Let me show you how I do that. So I'll just cut one of these designs out. Now the nice thing I like about this particular cutter, it has, and you might not be able to see in the camera, there is a line here that if I put just on the inside of my black line, that way I know that I can cut that away exactly. So you can see you definitely don't want this part on your sock because it's going to leave that mark. So I'll just cut that away, and then I'll do the exact same thing on the other side. Let me just do this really quick, and then I want to show you how I align this up on the sock. All Okay. So there's that done. And I will be pressing this design on the white sock, but I'll just demonstrate the alignment on this gray sock right here. So there's my design. This is the line that separates the toe, then goes into the main sock. So this is a little bit darker. This is a lighter gray. So all I'm going to do is just place that so that the bottom part of the paper, which is a straight edge, will fit perfectly along that line. And then I can center that piece of paper right on top of the sock. Now the reason this is important is so when you do the other sock, you can make that look exactly like the first sock. So I thought that was kind of a nice little tip. So you can see, let's see if you can see underneath where that's actually going to fall onto the sock. And then this part, you know, once the sock is on the foot, this will arch up a little bit. So I think that'll look nice. Like I said, I have not pressed these. So what is it they say? The proof will be in the pudding. So let me prepare the rest of these socks and then we'll take these out to the heat press and get them pressed. So the first thing that I'm going to do is just run the lint roller over the sock to remove any lint or dust that may be on there. And then I'm using a temporary adhesive spray. This is a brand that I prefer, but you can use any brand that you choose. And I'm just going to give my image a light misting with the spray. And then I'm going to put that image face down on the sock using the gray part of the sock as my alignment. And I've got my paper on the bottom, the sock, the print face down, and then I'll put another sheet of paper on top of that. Now my heat press is set for 400 degrees Fahrenheit, 60 seconds, and very light pressure. Now the light pressure will avoid you getting the marks from the paper. And if that does happen, just run your lint roller over it again and that should take care of it. But that came out perfect. Great color and no lines. So I'm going to set that aside and let it cool down. And then I'm going to repeat this process and do this on the reverse of the sock. So just a light spray of the adhesive. And here's the back of the sock. And I'm just going to use that gray line there to line it up. And then I think I'll just replace this blowout paper. Now, when I say blowout paper, it's just quite copy paper because I have some of that lying around. But you can use butcher paper as long as it's white or parchment paper, whatever your preference. So I'll just layer that up as I did before. And 60 seconds, 400 degrees. Very light pressure. And there we go, came out perfect. So these are pretty easy to do. So now that that's all done, let's go back into the house and take a closer look at these. All right, so we're back in from the heat press and here's the results. I think they came out really well. So you can see that mirrored image came out great. I think that adds some contrast to it. You could wear it anywhere you like. And then the backs of the feet, those came out great too. So let me take one of them out of the form. I wanted to see if any of the ink transferred onto the form. And it did. So these are doublers. One solution would be just to turn them in. If you really wanted to get more longevity out of these, you could wrap this or put a piece of parchment paper or butcher block paper in between, and that way you would get more use out of them. But still not too bad. It doesn't look like it did it on the back design, just that front design. So here's the sock, and let's have a look. I'll just put it on my hand as a demonstration. But yeah, that comes out pretty good. You figure it probably wouldn't stretch that much more on someone's foot, so that came out pretty nice. I like the placement of it. If you wanted, you could move it up a little bit more, but I think that looks good. And then I probably should have, now that I'm looking at this, I should have put this design the other way so that when someone's sitting with their foot up, that would read that way. So lesson learned, don't make the mistake that I just made. But still, I think they came out really good. So that's those two socks. I did do another little set. These are a bit dirty. I had dropped one on the floor, but I thought these were really cute for little kid size. And I didn't make the mistake on the feet part. So when their feet are up, it says, if you can read this, give me a kiss. So I thought that was really cute. So that's another pair that I made. And then I have a niece who likes that pop band, the Monster X. So I just whipped up a couple of these. I like the logo and I put the pink around it. I think that looks great against the gray. I haven't put anything on the reverse. I'm still trying to figure out what I want to put on there. So those are the socks that I did. I'm actually pretty happy with these. I hope you like these too. I mean, they are really fun to make, and with these being a high polyester count, it's maybe not the best for your feet, but you do get great vibrancy from the prints. So I'm very happy with that. So I think the next thing I'm going to do is try a wraparound design so that, you know, it goes all the way around the sock. I think I'll give that a go. So I might try that in a couple of weeks. So if you like this one, I hope that you like the video, subscribe, and don't forget to hit that notification bell so that you'll be notified of future videos. So again, I hope you've enjoyed this project, and thanks for watching.